British, Canadian and American troops who landed on the coast of France, north of the lovely town of Caen, in broad daylight this morning, are already several miles inland, on a front sufficiently broad to be more than a bridgehead. They are pushing steadily on, backed by the tremendous firepower of heavy British and United States warships, and covered by an ever-changing but ever-present umbrella of fighters. The first phase of the great operation began about midnight last night when a force of parachutists and glider troops, some of which I saw taking off in the dying light of yesterday, landed on the eastern side of the chosen area to secure that flank. Today, the gliders and some of the discarded parachutes lie like crumpled flowers in the wet, wooded countryside northeast of Caen. Evidence enough that our airborne troops have successfully completed this, the first of their operations in the new battle of Europe. West of them, lying in a broad sweep rounding towards the peninsula of Cherbourg, are the beaches on which British, Canadians and Americans made an early breakfast time landing.